So, hello everyone.
Hey everyone.
So, in today's video, we are going to talk about some of the most annoying habits that each gender here should quit in 2019. So, for those joining us for the first time, my name is Daniel.
My name is Esther.
And let's get on with it.
Yeah.
So, the first point, Esther.
The very first point.
Ladies first.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So, the very first point I want to say.
Have you seen there? Have you seen what I've done?
And I've appreciated myself.
Personal
thank
growth.
You.
I've talked about personal growth.
I'll say thank you.
It's all about personal growth.
Why are you telling me to do this?
Okay, you have your point there.
Anyway, the very first point I want to put it, right, is that guys should make their intentions clear.
Yeah.
If you like a lady,
let
her know by telling her. If you want her to be your girlfriend, just ask. You know, make those requests known so that when she's in it, she'll be knowing.
Yeah.
Yeah, where how the position is.
Okay, that's subject to different interpretations. But, okay, what an argument that maybe I can put on the table is that you've been, if maybe you are being keen on social media, there's been this joke about how to begin conversations in a month. So if that is a problem, how do you expect me to just say to Esther, can you be my girlfriend? You see?
Do you remember? Let's go to the point.
Sometimes
you
just let things
it's
slide.
It's personal growth. We said we want personal growth.
Yeah.
So let us not just be caught up in our past and in our fears. And because when I want something from you, if I ask, hey, Dan, please, can you help me that glass of water? And like, Kai Dan, you can't see nataka maji. I'm a nipichi of maji. I'm a siyo maji ngeku imefika hapa. You see? So it's kind of real.
Okay guys, you've heard it. I don't know what your opinions on that, but
let me hear from you ladies.
Okay,
let
me just I'm a bit tongue tied with that.
We'll see in the comments.
Okay, my turn.
Yeah.
So guys, what you should watch out for these kinds of ladies when you go out, she's not leaving the table that you have wherever you are seated. Yeah? She's just dancing with her. You know the way they dance with their shoulders. I don't know, how do you dance? Can you just
No, I don't know.
I
dance alongside.
Yeah, so they just dance with their shoulders and then they do their hair like this. That habit you guys don't like. You know, like we have gone out, we expect you to at least get down with it. Get down, and then you are there, like you're in the table there, your phone. Where's my phone? And then can you just show them how you do it?
No, those things are like on point, and then I'm like,
yeah, that's an annoying habit. You know, when you go out with people, make a habit of being jolly with it. Yeah, do whatever crazy stuff they're doing, but not so crazy to be illegal. But you know, get to the groove.
Dance,
don't just
dance.
Do your hair like
enjoy the moment
and shake your shoulders
and the selfie thing.
So me, I find that one. Now your turn.
So the second point is, I find it so annoying when guys. It's disturbing, not annoying, it's kind of disturbing when guys adjust themselves in public places. The guy is just like doing like his introza or tucking things in. If it doesn't fit you, please change. If it doesn't,
I have a countdown for that. Can you just stomach it off for the camera? Just
No, don't do that.
So if guys are adjusting,
because like for us, you
I just wanted to show, I don't want to show that.
Uh-huh.
If guys, you complain that guys are adjusting their trousers. We have several reasons, you know. For example, maybe you might have one just slightly oversized, and it's hanging, and some of us don't like sagging, so we have to adjust it. But if you don't like that, also us, I want to react negatively but positively. Those ladies who wear sundresses, also if the wind blows you, don't adjust it, just leave it there.
Yeah, we just do like this. For me, when it comes like this, I just do like
that's adjusting.
Because for us ladies, we don't go in public. Imagine if we could go to public and doing like this our boobs.
But
it's okay.
Since I joined campus, the friends I've been having, their pants waist size, So I can mention some few Kenadeno and Anto, So no one has been doing that
doing
high
that
school
too.
Stuff. You know, high school though. Apparently it looked cool, Cindy. Contact shot and everything.
No, this one I see.
Guys, 2019 is all about growth. I agree, Esther.
They avoid.
Cindy, don't adjust, Cindy. Show your boxer, Cindy. And also, ladies, if that dress comes up and it's windy,
you
don't
just
adjust
like
it because Esther doesn't like adjusting stuff. I hope. Okay, my second part.
The next one.
The second point is It's all about also outdoors.
Yeah.
I have gone with you out, Cindy. Maybe somewhere we have not been to Cindy. For example, let's assume that we have not been to the Hub Car in Cindy.
Yeah.
Then now there's Nini. See, there are different restaurants there. Cindy, there's that one for Steers, I don't know what. Cindy, yeah. So there are these kinds of chicks who are always looking for that new vocabulary in the menu that they've never heard of. At the, they have seen something there at the bushfire.
And then you go ask for bushfire, expecting what to come. What is in your mind when you ask
and
for
then,
that?
Worst off,
if you don't know,
she will not finish it, and then she will be like, I wanted it medium, I don't know, medium fries.
It's overcooked.
Yeah, it's overcooked.
It's not well cooked inside, there's blood.
That stuff just ruins our mood. You know, she ordered something, obviously bushfire is going to be something expensive. You
don't
expect something with a good vocabulary,
yeah?
To be cheap, and then. So don't get in the habit of just looking for new vocabularies in the menu and then you decide there.
It comes and it's embarrassing and you don't know what
that's
to do.
Yeah,
oh
that's
my god,
point.
That's
my
day true.
Yeah.
Anyway, but let's see. Another one I would want to say is that for guys, almost similar to the previous, is that if you want to do something to ask a lady to go out, please ask nicely.
Yeah.
Like for instance, Valentine is coming. We will be waiting for those who are dating or have friends. We'll be waiting to to just be asked, request, you know, can we go? You know, we have made some booking somewhere.
Also, you don't like me saying that the Esther Oga twin?
Twin, yeah. No, that's better. That's better. See, you like?
Yeah.
Twin day. And you don't know, even know where you're going, or you don't know.
So
Ama, unachuka twin day. You know, they're not putting it
but
right.
But I think you're confused there because. Ladies like surprises. Cindy,
yeah, we do.
Eh?
Yes, that's true.
You know, for example, I might be Nini. You know, I might decide to surprise you, Cindy. Niseme Hilton, Cindy. So, you know, maybe you've never been to Hilton, Cindy. So, if I surprise you and say just friend, and then you reach there and find it's Hilton,
yeah, it's
good.
Going to be
but it's all gamble. I might also surprise you at Potane Palingara at home. So you see,
at times that's why it's good to know where you're going.
Yeah,
so that you
I
know even the
like
dressing. But because you can imagine somebody could pack a makeup, you know, it takes time. And then we pack a makeup with stilettos.
Yeah.
And let me tell you the thing, it's not
okay,
easy
okay,
to put on those things.
Okay, now.
Kufika place,
yeah.
Town, napata unanipeleka place, you know. As I fit the outfit.
Okay, just to summarize this point you're saying. So how should we say it?
If
how should we ask nicely?
How you should ask nicely?
Yeah.
Like make it clear. Like, hey, I have something. I want us to go out for dinner. You know, that way
also
I'll
we should
target.
Like say
yeah.
Like,
and then when I put
do you want to go for dinner? And then we should like
okay.
Say 2 hours earlier to allow you to change.
Yeah,
your clothes,
to make everything
to
change
your clothes,
everything. And then
you
know,
to even
you,
go to
you
the
can
salad.
Actually add up.
And then
you know to make everything. And you can even top up and say, hey, make sure you look nice. When you tell me that, I'll know like, hey, I need to be good. But she says, in you know, I can come let me vibe out, and then I'm like.
So I think we've had it. So asking nicely.
Yeah.
2 hours prior. To allow them to go to the salon, to allow them to just to
yeah.
Allow them to wash. You know the good thing is also their you know your clothes they dry fast, so maybe you may be having that Sunday best and it's dirty, so you just clean it up and
And
so don't surprise them. So don't surprise and ambush girls. You know. Okay, my point. So I'm going to talk about being social. I really like people who are social.
Oh, I also thought the same. Also not the same.
I really like people who are social.
Mm-hmm.
So the issue is that I don't like girls, for example, you were talking about girls.
Yeah.
I don't like girls who when you go out, Cindy, you're like, I came here with dying. You know, I came here with my phone. You know, I like people who are social.
Yeah,
Cindy,
that's
you true. Might find that the host is maybe not interesting. Cindy, I was surprised that if it's a house party, maybe you don't drink. Cindy, and there's no soda there. Cindy, now you're like, oh, Esther, Dan, you're just like cleaning. Cindy, you don't have like me.
Don't have
Cindy, and let me just go further and say that last year, there was a lady friend told me that, you see, like, for example, let me not put it in the context of marrying, but something similar.
Mm-hmm.
You see, when I'm with you, I'm like, you know, let me say about marriage. You see, marriage is like, when you're, she said that when you marry,
mm-hmm.
you're married to that person's home, not Daniel. You know, so like you have to learn to get along with everyone
everybody.
There.
That's
so
important.
I just believe that if also you are grooving with someone, Cindy, Cindy. So as the next time, if you go out, maybe you've gone to watch a movie and before the movie starts,
Cindy,
you always do that. It's just like dan. No. I'm like, no, he is special. Yeah, everybody does it. But guys, not guys, you ladies, try and at least don't be so antisocial.
I think it applies to both gender and trans conversations.
Let me just say that if you bring a lady next to a man and you introduce her and she doesn't
talk.
Yeah, I think
the guys go silent as well.
I'm saying that's just a unique case. We are always ready and willing to mingle with the opposite sex.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will also add to that.
Yeah.
Guys need to, talk. You know, I hate it when I'm talking to my friends and they have the earphones on and we're having a conversation. So I speak it all and then they don't add to my udaku. You know, it's always sweet when you add something on top. You make the story more juicier and interesting. So I don't like it when I'm speaking something and then somebody else is on phone or they're acting as if they're busy somewhere. I feel like I get distracted. Yeah, it's irritating and
now what's more irritating? Today I saw it on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
There's, I don't know, you see the way where you hook your charger?
Yeah, charger. Yeah.
I don't know, it's an iPhone or what. They've come up with some casing, which is a port,
uh-huh.
So that you can add, you can put your fork or your knife or your spoon, so that you do not leave your phone even if you're eating. You know, the way you are eating like this, you don't have to, it's there, so you can just cook it.
Oh,
no,
my God, this technology is killing people.
In the next five years, nowadays we are rapidly buying those technologies. So next year I'm sure guys will be having those fork and Esther.
Yeah.
So that there you'll just be disappointed.
I'm actually wondering why in this age why we still don't have flying cars or something.
But you hate that, you hate anything that directs attention from you. So why do you want those flying cars if they'll be there?
Because in 2000 people are saying by now we'll be having them.
It's there, it's just,
and the world will have.
Now you see, that's another problem. When you're talking to ladies, they just go off topic. We're just talking about annoying habits and now she's already gone to flying cars. I've got to that, all right?
Yeah,
I've got to
that. Okay.
So that's it, guys, for today. We don't want to make the video so long.
Mm-hmm.
I hope you liked it.
So if you haven't subscribed, make sure you hit the subscribe button and also the notification so that you get the notice on when
anytime
and what time
we promise you they're going to be coming at a steady interval, so please, if you put the notification button, it will be
also. Make sure you comment.
Make sure you comment.
Let's hear your thoughts
comments,
and some of the annoying habits that guys should leave in 2018. You should not move with them in 2019 as we progress. We want growth, and that's with ourselves, myself. If we become better, everything will be good. So, see you next time.
So, thank you so much for watching.